Hey, it's time we do the hero banner, and what we're going to do is have a pretty simple one: background image, main headline, subheader, maybe a bit of text and a button. You should be in a good position where you now understand a lot of the basics of Bricks and the class system as well, because we are going to be utilizing that as we build this. So the first thing we're going to do is add in a section and a container. Now, a lot of what I'm doing here, you could do without actually having a container. There's two schools of thought here. Some people say add it in, some people say don't. I'm going to leave it in, but I do want to let you know that everything I shove into the container, eventually, I could have deleted it and just done straight into the section, but I just want to make that clear right now in case anyone goes, well, why you got the container? Because you don't really need it. But for simplicity, I'm going to leave it in. Now, the first thing we're going to do is go over to the section, and I'm going to set the height of this section. So I'm going to go to layout, I'm going to go down to the height, and I'm going to set this to be 700 pixel. What I'm also going to do on the section, if I go to content, is down here where we have align main axes, I'm going to put this on the center. Now, if you forget to do this, don't worry. In fact, what I'll do is let me undo it, and then you'll understand in about a couple of minutes time why I put that in the center. So let's just leave that like that. The second thing I want to do is on the container is go to content again, is I'm going to stretch it. The reason I stretch is if you don't, you'll have a bit of spacing on the left and right. Sections are full width. Containers are practically full width with a little bit of spacing from the left and right. It's not all the way across. So I want to stretch it all. Now let's go to our section and give it a background image. Now I'm going to go to style, I'm going to go to background, click over here and pick an image. Now I've got some WebP images. I strongly recommend, if you're getting your image from Canva, Photoshop, wherever you are, and it's in high quality PNG, use bulkresizephotos.com and convert it down to a WebP. It will make a big difference on your size and your page speed score. Let's just drop this image in here. I do not know this person. It is just a stock image, okay? Great idea is to leave your resolution as full, even though you might go, but my image isn't even that big. No, keep it in full, because that's to do with your resolution. Set this to be a center left. I could go for center. Look, the image moves over. I could go for center right. It moves over a bit more. But I think the center left works pretty well for what I'm trying to get here. There will be no repeat on the background. Now, this one is important, background size. I never use auto. I rarely use custom. If I use contain, can you see what it's doing? It's now fitting the entirety of the image into the estate. Bit dangerous unless you are very particular about the size of your screen or what you are showing. But 99% of the time, I will go for cover. The great thing about cover is that it kind of fits it in. Please bear in mind, though, that you might get a bit of slicing off the top, the bottom, the left and right. So ensure the focal point of your image is nicely in the center or has a bit of padding somewhere in the image. So if there's a bit of cutoff cropping, you're not going to be overly fussed. Now into the container, what we're going to do is drop in a heading. So make sure you clicked on container and click heading. Now you can't see it because I haven't really styled it yet. And also you can't see it because, do you remember I said the section, if we go over to layout, sorry, content, well, if I undo that, everything is at the top. So because we have a sticky header, that heading is actually below or behind the sticky header. You can't see it. So if I was to go over here right now to heading, and I was to type in some text like that, you can't see it. This is the point where you could go over to style and start styling your header because you want to see it and you want it to be a white font and blah, blah, blah. But if you do that and avoid the class system, you're creating more work for yourself later on. So what I recommend you do is I'm clicked on the heading. Okay, I'm actually going to call this hero heading. I'm going to go over here and I'm going to type in hero heading like that. We're going to hit save. So we've now created a class. It is in yellow. Everything I do will now be applied to that class. I'm going to go to the typography. I'm going to set this to be a white color on the palette. I'm also going to say make it be, we'll go with about 5 REM for now. I might make it bigger. Can you now see some of the wording you can see? By the way, if you're wondering what it says, if I go to content, it says maximizing websites and mentoring designers. Well, at the minute, I can see a bit of the G curling over and I can only see the designers. Let's sort that out. Don't worry, I will come back to modify the hero heading with the class, but let's just go to section, and down here where we have the align main axes, I'm going to do that. And it goes down to the center. Go to the bottom, you know, stretch it out's not really going to do much because there's not much content in there. But you could, if you want, my recommendation when you're building something is get it in the center, especially if you have a sticky header, because you might go, well, where's my wording gone? Let's go back to hero heading. I'm just going to click this again to ensure it is yellow. We're back in the style. It is a white font. It is 5REM. It is left aligned. I mean, it's already going to be left aligned. I didn't really need to touch that. I'm going to ensure it is uppercase. Now, I'm not keen on the way the and is there. I want the and to wrap over, but let me just still do some styling. Let's go to letter spacing, and I'm going to do 0.2REM. By the way, if you put in like a 1REM like that, that's a bit too spaced out. So I'm going to go for 0.2REM like that. Just a little bit of spacing. Now, is the line height okay? Yeah, I'm okay with that at the moment. You could have adjusted it. Look, if I was to go like that, you could put values in there. Now, I'm not going to do anything else to it. By the way, though, in my settings in previous video, in theme styles, in typography, I've already set my body to be, well, not my body, but the website, right? I've already set it to be a custom font, which is Latto. So when I come over to my headings over here, it has already pulled that through. So again, you can either do it in your theme style, or if you don't preset it over there, you could come here and then set it, because it's now within the class, right? So within the class, you could set it there as well. Again, it's these tips and things I would recommend you have a think about with where you're going to set it, because maybe you're going to have a different style, but you can still overwrite as well. So just because it's defaulted to Latto, I can quite happily go over here and pick something different for this particular class. The other thing also is this is currently set to 700. Yeah, we'll leave, in fact, I'll just make sure it's definitely, yeah, it is 700. We'll leave it like that. Now let me come back onto addressing what's happening over here. So let me go to the content tab. If I click here and I hit return, I've now got the wrap, which looks great. That's what I wanted. But there is a danger that maybe when you get onto, say, certain breakpoints, you might have like websites and then it wraps over to and. So it might not look right. Let me go to container. Let me go to style. This container, in terms of layout, is basically full width. However, I want to control that. So I'm going to go in and say, make this be 1,100 in width. Like that. Pixels, by the way. In fact, let me just undo that. I really should stop rushing, right? Let me just show you how this looks if we just go to preview. Can you see that? It's stretching all the way across. Not completely all the way here, but that's because of the size of the wording. Let's go back over here. Let's make that be 1,000. Now, there is no right or wrong answer, but normally I like to work with 1,100. On hero banners, I bring it in slightly bit more because I don't want the words fully stretched out. You can go for 1,200, but on a Surface Pro and some MacBooks and some laptops, it will look right up against the edge. But on a hero banner, 1,100 is fine. 1,000 is okay as well. You can go smaller if you want. Just don't go too big. Now, if we save this and go over to preview, can you now see? Look, I mean, I love it how Bricks gives you these little prompts. Hey, grand, this is amazing. But you've now got maximizing websites and mentoring designers. And it's kind of now, it's almost in the right place. But I do still want that and to carriage return. And I'm now feeling like the wording is too big. And this is the thing where you can modify your styling. So I go to hero heading. We're still in yellow. If it wasn't, you know, if it was like this and the yellow is missing, just click it to reactivate. So at this point, I now need to make a decision. Do I want to apply custom width to every hero heading? Because I'm only going to use it in a few places or only when I decide. So I am going to undo that. This is still using the hero heading class, but the changes I make here are now unique to this particular element. So if I go and type in 50%, and to be honest, that does look okay. That kind of return of the designers actually does give you a nice little triangular sloping approach there. So we will keep that in. Now I'm going to add in a divider line. So let's just go and click that. Now when I click it, it's kind of gone outside of the container. So I'm just going to pick it up and just move it over there. Now you can't see the divider because we haven't set anything yet. So I'm going to go to content, give it a color using our color. Now it is stretching all the way across. Don't worry, we are going to adjust that. We're going to ensure it is definitely a solid. It's already defaulted there. I have a force of habit where I sometimes still go and pick it, even though it's there, just because I want to be sure that it does do that. The direction is horizontal. It's going to be a line to start. This will become important in a moment, okay? I'm not going to add in any icon, but the width of it, I'm actually going to make this be about 40%. Now you can just about see it over here, okay? It'll become clearer when we do the preview, and I'm going to give this a height of 2 pixels. Let me just save that and let's go to preview. There's the line. Now, if I had gone for 100%, it would basically stretch all the way across over there, which is not what I want. And if I had gone and done this with the alignment, like moved it to the center, if we now preview that, it's now in the center. So hopefully that's making a bit more sense with how the divider works. The obvious issue you have here at the moment is that it's way too close to what we have there with the main headline. So I'm going to go to my divider, go to style, go to layout, we'll go with 20 at the top and 20 at the bottom, so that when I add in my next item, it's going to kind of be okay and there'll already be that spacing. So let's go ahead and get started with that. Now I'm going to duplicate my hero heading. I'm going to pick it up and put it below the divider. I'm now going to go over here and I'm literally going to just get rid of everything we had. So at this point, you're probably wondering, why did you do that? You duplicated it and then you got rid of the class. Now you got to start all over again. Well, here's my logic. If you go to style, this has already kept the 59%. So by duplicating, it remembers that in there. So if you've gone and added in any margins or paddings or anything like that, you can actually make your workload more efficient. To be honest, I've jumped the gun here where I should have checked this out in mobile. So when I duplicate it over, once I've done the breakpoints for the mobile as well, it would have brought it over. I am jumping the gun a little bit here because I don't want this video to become stagnant and boring and I want to keep it flowing, but I will come back to address that in a moment. Now we're going to rename this one to be main heading. And then over here, we are now going to call, we're going to create a class system, hit save. We're going to dump in some words, new words now. Don't forget though, I mean, I would say depending on your keywords, if your keyword was over here, you want to make this be a H1. Or if your keyword is down here, make that be the H1. But what you really want to do is make sure that your hero banner heading and your next main heading or subheading, whatever you call it, are H1s or H2s. Okay, because that's quite important when you come to do keywords. And we've got videos on rank math. Please go and have a look at them. So we've gone and added in some wording there. We're going to go to style. We are still on the main heading. If we go to the typography, it is still going to be Lato. We are going to make this be a thinner font. In fact, we'll go with 400 there. And we'll adjust, well, we'll make the font be white. I'm going to go with a 3rem there. This is already text aligned. I'm not going to do any transforming. I don't have to do this. Force of habit with how I like to work sometimes, especially if I'm handing over to a client so they know this is what we had picked, but you don't have to do that. So far, so good. And everything is centered in the middle at the moment. Let's now add in some text below. Now you have two options, basic text or rich text. I would say rich text can sometimes help you out a little bit more if you want to do some funkier stuff. However, if you're just keeping it really, really simple, you could just go with basic as well. There is no right or wrong answer on here. However, you're going to start messing around with a bit of HTML and stuff like that, or a bit of coding, the rich text can help you out. So we've gone and got our basic text over here. Now I'm not going to be, I didn't duplicate the headings and then create my text, because the headings, well, they're headings. This is text. So we're going to create a completely different class system here now. Now I'm going to call this one standard text. You could call it body text or something like that. So we're going for standard text. Go with 1.8 REM. It is already left aligned. And I am going to set the weight of this to be 400 as well over here. It's already defaulted to Lato. Set the color to actually be one of these darker charcoal-y colors like that. Now, trust me, you're probably saying, well, that was the worst mistake you ever made, because now we definitely can't see it. But that is now applied to the standard text wherever I use it. However, for this particular one, I'm going to remove the class name from being yellow. The class is still applied. Okay, don't get me wrong, the class is still applied, but now I can go in and add in a bit of individuality. So whenever I add that class name, standard text, to any text now, it will always be defaulted to the charcoal color. But on the fly, I can go, right, yeah, just make sure it's not in yellow, and we're going to give it a white color like that. Let's just drop in our text content, and we're just going to drop that in there. Now, it should be pretty obvious that this is a little bit cramped up, and also we've got way too much white going on. So I'm going to go to my basic text, go to style, make sure it's not in yellow, go to layout, and we're just going to give it about 20, and we'll go with 20 again from the bottom, because I am still going to add in a button, don't forget. Now, what I will do, though, is go back to my main heading. I'm going to ensure that it is not in yellow, so if it was like this, I would undo that, because the class is still applied for the main heading, but I'm going to do a change which is only going to be relevant for this particular one. We're going to go to typography, and I'm now going to change the color for this to be a little bit gray, okay? Just so we have a little bit of variation over there on what we see on the screen. Now, what we're going to do is add in our button. Pretty simple, really. We're just going to click on the plus sign, go and find button, click it. If it puts it in the wrong place, just pick it up and drag it into where you want it to be. Because we added in 20 pixels to the bottom of the basic text or the standard text, it is now given us a bit of space. And let's go to the button. Now, remember, you could either create everything you want to do now or save yourself time, be efficient, and create a class. Call it button style. We'll hit save. I'm going to give this a strong black color as the text. 2 REM for the size. We're going to make it be quite weighty. Going to make it be uppercase like that. And give this a background color of yellow. So it kind of blends. Well, it kind of fits the branding, right? As I'm sure you can see that already. And by default, the button has already got 10, 10, 20, 20 on the left and right in terms of padding. You may decide you want to change that, make it bigger, bolder. If you want to do that, fine, do it. Just remember, because it's on the button style, it will apply it all across the board. If you're happy with that, go with it. If you only want it to be for this particular button, then take off the yellow. I would say keep things consistent and apply it across the board, top and bottom, and 25 on the left and right. You can give it a circular border if you want. You can give it a bit of an outline. I'm not fussed about that, to be honest. I'm not going to add in any icon. What you would do is click over here, pick an icon from the library. You know, you can do your sizing, how far is it from the wording, etc. But the key bit is over here with the link type. Now, a lot of you might not be used to this because you just drop a link in. Now you got to be a bit specific. Is it an internal post? So where is it going? And then you would pick your page to wherever it's going over there. Or is it going to be an external URL? So it's sending them to websquadron.co.uk. That's us, by the way. So you get to decide on that. I'm going to leave it pretty clean at the moment like that. So what we have there is a very basic hero banner, okay? I mean, what I will say, though, over here, there is a little bit of a problem because this here is now wrapping over onto the man's arm. So I want to very quickly just make a change there. If you remember, the two headings were 59%. The basic text doesn't have that applied. Now, if I apply 59%, I don't think it's really going to make much of a difference. The word consultation wraps over. So I'm now going to change this. And sometimes when you're designing websites, you will fluctuate a little bit and then you'll find what works best for you. Now, I'm just going to go over here and I'm going to make this be about 40%. So we get a bit more of an overlap going on there with regards to the wording. So if I now save that and preview, that is now looking like that. Now, you might be okay with that. You might go, oh, I prefer this to be higher up. Well, okay, your section, go over to your content and instead put this at the top like that. Then go over to style and then in your padding, give it about 100 pixels like that. So you can now see it's now more towards the top. What if I wanted to have another button side by side to this button here? So I'm just going to go here and I'm going to duplicate. This button also has button style applied, okay? But what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to the style, go to background and give this a completely different color. That is only going to be applied to the second button, okay? But they're still using the button style, which is the typography, the padding and all of that. Now, this button sits side by side. I want it to be next. Sorry, it's below. I want it to be next door. Let's just go and change some of the contents of this button. So how do we get that to be side by side? Let's go back to our container. Now, please bear in mind, in the section, we've set the alignment and the padding, but the contents sit within a container. They're wrapped up within the container, okay? If we go over here, it is stretched, but everything is defaulted to be columnar, okay? If I hit horizontal row, this happens, okay? Now, I've intentionally done this just to kind of go, well, you could have just moved on now to responsive mode, but I feel it's important to address that. What if you now want another button side by side, and now you go for this horizontal row approach? Well, now everything looks completely mucked up. Not really easy to sort out. first thing you want to do is wrap it. Over here, flex wrap. Okay, great. We are now wrapping. So now things are starting to wrap. So we've still got our text, we've got our divided line, and we've got our word, but our basic text is now next door to it. We need to do something about that. Here's where you got to be a little bit careful now. If I go to this main heading and I go to style and I go to layout, down here, this had 59%. If I increase this to be, say, well, 68%, it is now pushed the basic text to go below. But now we're out of sync with what we had above. So this is where you got to think a little bit carefully. I am going to make this be 100% in width. It goes all the way across, okay? This is where you now got to just mess around a little bit with how you build things. 100%. Now I'm going to go over, though, to my padding on the right. I mean, you could do it on the padding. You could do it on the margin, okay? Probably margin's better, actually. So we were originally doing 59%. So I'm going to type in here 41%. It's pretty logical maths, right? I've made it be 100%, so it makes the next item wrap onto the next row. But I now want that to still be 59. Okay, you're going adding 41% for your margin. Now we've got the same problem going here. Okay, fine, let's go to our basic text. It is 40%, you can see it there. Let's make it be 100% like that. And then again, go over to the margin and I'm gonna type in 60. There we go. We're now back to where we are. So in the column approach, we weren't really fussed by that. Over here, we are kind of manipulating a little bit, so we are now forcing everything to wrap. We now have the button side by side. Perfect, right? Well, not really. Let's just go to button 2. Let's now just give this a little bit of margin. How about 20 pixels or even 25 maybe? But I think 25 might be better. So on your hero banner, maybe you don't just want one call to action, you want two call to actions. This is how you would do it. But we've got to address the elephant in the room, the mobile view. Okay, you go over here and all of a sudden it looks like this. Not so great now, is it? The number one reason why it doesn't look great is, well, yes, I know the padding and margins all look wrong as well, but when you go to the section in the mobile view, if you go to style and you go to background, the image is brought over. Okay, so don't get me wrong here. It says there's no image. The image is brought over. However, it's the wrong orientation. Landscape image on a portrait sized mobile, it just does not work. So what you got to do is bring over another image. Now let me show you the trick as to how you want to do this. Click on the B to go back into WordPress, go over to your media library. Now I've already got this image. If you haven't got a copy of this image, click it, get the URL, download it and add it in again. But I can add this one in again. So I have a copy of the image. I'm going to click it. Okay, you could do this outside in Photoshop, Canva, any other tool. I sometimes like to do it when I'm actually working on the site. So I'm going to click edit image, right? And the first thing I'm going to do is scale this. Don't crop it. I'm going to scale it first. So over here, I'm going to say scale this to be 700 tall. I'm not worried about the width because I'm going to crop it, but it must be 700. Now, when you've done that, after you've hit scale, hit X. Because if you now jump to crop, it undoes the scale and then it's cropping the original size, which ain't great. Go back into the image. It's 1244 by 700. Let's hit edit image. Let's hit crop. I'm going to just do this so I can get the line. My face is covering the selection part down here, but you have over here 700. Leave that as it is. But over here, you have the width. I'm going to set that to be about 500. And I'm now going to maneuver this to be, well, how do I kind of want it to look on the screen? Let's hit crop. Okay, now let's hit save. I now have a different image. There's the horizontal one we used on the desktop and you might use on your tablet, landscape or anything like that. This is now a different sized image. Let's now insert it. Now, if I go back to desktop, I still have the desktop image. Look, it's full width going all the way across. On the mobile, I have a different sized image. That is how you do it. That is how you kind of make things work better for you. And it helps out with your page speed performance as well, especially if you get errors like this image is too big or whatever like that. All we're going to do is start adjusting things, okay? So I'm going to go to my section. I'm going to go to my padding and I'm going to say, give me 20 on the left and right. Let's now go to the hero heading. Now, if you notice here, the hero heading is not in yellow. I'm going to activate it because whatever I do here, I want it to apply to that hero heading class on the mobile as well. The desktop is intact because we're on the mobile breakpoint. Okay, so whatever we do here only applies to the mobile. Let's now go down here to the typography. We don't need to touch the color because that's brought over from the desktop one, even though you go, well, where's the color? It is brought over. We're now going to set the sizing. I'm going to go with 3rem. The main heading is okay in terms of its width. However, the style of it does need adjusting. So let's click main heading because we want this to apply across the board whenever we do it again. Let's go to typography. I've changed it to be 2.5rem. Let's go to the basic text. Again, you know, the same thing. I click the standard text. I go to font style. This was 1.8 before. I think 1.8 still does actually work. The only thing, though, is that this does look a little bit cramped up because of the size at the moment. So let's go to layout instead. I've removed the yellow class because this is obviously going to be a certain size because I've got this person of interest over here. Let's now just touch the minimum width, and 55% works quite well. We've got the buttons down here. Now, we definitely want to adjust this, so I'm going to put the button style on. I'm going to make that be 1.6rem. Now, you may not have noticed this because I kind of typed it really quick. Let me just undo what I just typed there. Look at the size of these fonts. If I go and type in 1rem, it's applied it to both buttons because both of them are using that button style over here. This is really, really, really important, okay? That button style is now going to be applied to both. So I'm just going to pop that back over to 1.6. Now, one word of warning that I should have mentioned earlier on, and I'm sorry I didn't, is that this currently is a mobile breakpoint of 477. I can tell you now an iPhone XR size screen is actually 378 or 379, 378. So if you were to go to 378 like this, you can now see a little bit more adjustment is required. I mean, look, the image looks completely off for starters. So just bear that in mind when you are adjusting. So I've just gone and very quickly just adjusted the sizes a tiny bit there just so it looks okay. Now, one thing that is sticking out like a sore thumb is this sticky header, and it's got a different background color. And I actually now want that to be a transparent color. So this is what I'm going to do very quickly. I'm going to go over up here and click edit header. That will open it up in another menu and I can do that. I'm going to go to my section, go to style, clear that background color completely. And I am going to go to my nav menu and I'm going to change the typography of that. And I'm just going to make it white just for really quick, simplistic reasons. I'm now going to save that. I now have a completely transparent header. So as you scroll up and down the page, I mean, that is a sticky header, by the way. It's got a scrolling effect of red, which I am going to get rid of. Ignore that red. Ignore the red, okay? So when you've done your header, if you are going to have a sticky header, just be aware of the overlap. If you have got a particular color on there, again, be aware of that. As we continue building the website, I will be putting on a scroll background color onto this, but I hope you found that useful with the hero banner. It is quite a simplistic one, but you know, we went over the container, you know, the section settings, the container, wrapping, row, especially the mobile, the class system and how you can get it to help you out, especially when we go forwards with other sections, which we will be doing in future videos. I'm Imran Web Squadron. Like, subscribe, share, and follow. I'll see you. Never break, always fight, never quit, do it right, play the game, win it life, have no shame, there's no time, feel the pain, live the grind, I could change, in my mind, pick a lane, commit and climb, the only way, to win it life, I never miss, that's fact, taking big swings, bitch, hand me the bat, put me in the ring, you'll go out in a bag.